Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. As the players get in, that final stretch just about set to kick it off with some Big 12 action. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
And NASA will host this exciting college football contest that's coming up. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Cooper has the ball set how he wants it. And we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks.
Collier from the one.
He's tackled
at the 25-yard line.
Senior class taking the home field for the final time. And no matter what you've done before, you always want to get a win in your last home game. We'll see how they do.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
He makes it to the 25-yard line.
Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
He's under pressure. Quick throw out to the receiver.
And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Fitzpatrick comes away with about 2 yards on a little draw play.
It's a good run blitz by the outside linebacker there. They shut down all the holes and kept this halfback from gaining many yards.
Fires quickly to the tight end. Tackle made around the 42-yard line. Third down. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner.
And they push him out
at about the 45.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
Here's the tight end open, but he drops the ball. From the 45-yard line. Second down. Pass broken up.
You know, that actually might have been a break for the offense. Sometimes tip passes can linger in the air and get picked off.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Fires it out.
And down he goes at the 42. They couldn't get the first down.
Well, here they were hoping to get a few extra yards after the catch. Give the defense credit. They held him short.
Edmonds is set back, ready to punt. He'll probably try to pooch this one into the corner. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The Cougars' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. On the run.
Brought down at the 32. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And he's taken down around the 35-yard line. Tries to buy some time, and they make the stop at the 35.
Willis has got to forget about all the distractions, and that includes talking about winning awards. And in talking to him, he seems like a pretty focused, driven guy, and I think he's all about team.
They come out in a five-wide set. He's on the run. Tackle around the 45-yard line. And he has a huge game.
And I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
He scrambled. And he is drilled at the 49. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's going to try and scramble. He's at the 40. Fumble, loose ball. Defense says they've got it, and they do. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
He's tackled at the 38-yard line.
The penetration by the defense was so good on that play that it didn't matter who the ball carrier was. Anyone would have been brought down for a loss.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 38. Run there.
That's good work. That'll bring up third and eight.
That's a fumble. It's scooped up, and he's stopped behind the line.
Lee is back awaiting the punt.
Tackle at the 40-yard line.
Here comes the offense. No doubt looking to take better care of the ball on this drive.
The defense, I'm sure, will be aggressive again. They love going for the strip and attacking the football.
Pressured and brought down.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Fisher was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make a third and 13.
I got you, punk.
Hey, go Mike 40, Mike 40.
Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line.
Thank you.
So at the end of one quarter, still no score. We're all tied up as we head into quarter number two.
Zips it to the back. He's taken down at about the 29-yard line.
That's a big gain there for the offense, and all that's doing is giving this quarterback more and more confidence.
Pulls it in, and that's a first down. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Let's go!
And they'll bring him down behind the line.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 9-yard line.
Let's go, D.
McCall gets it on the inside. He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line.
That makes it 30 more.
Mike 40.
Watch the run, Patriot.
Now he's scrambling. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. This one should be makeable. Houston could take the lead with this field. It's up, and the field goal is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding the field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
First down.
It's the tailback. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That makes it 7-8.
He's got it out to his tight end, and he's tackled at the 49-yard line. Hit immediately.
Call it a gain of 18 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Two times.
Three down.
Check 36.
Makes it to the 21. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
Under heavy pressure. There's a missed tackle. Swings it to his tight end, but he drops it.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line.
Two down.
Hey, check my hand.
Gets gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made at the 11.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. He might have a chance. Touchdown, Bobcats. Quarterback just made that one look pretty simple.
Well, this quarterback isn't your average player. He runs the option very well and gives this defense fits.
And he converts the extra point. A nice 7-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 7-3. Lee takes it at the 8. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Houston's going to use their first time out of the half here. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. Caught, open field, and down he goes at the 36-yard line. Midfield, and they finally push him out at the 32-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. They come out on an empty backfield. Scrambling around. Brought down at the 30-yard line.
That's a good gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Mike 40. Larry.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Slings it. And he's taken down at the 12-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 12. Just throws this one away. Point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Cooper is lined up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
Well, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other right back into it. This is exciting.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
And a nice catch there. Out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on their own 38.
Caught out in the open.
He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 38-yard line.
First down, go. Ball on the 38.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field.
And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line. Caldwell picks up around 5 yards with that catch. Texas State will take their first time out of the half. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
And he just gets rid of it. And this brings up an interesting situation.
If you have faith in your kicker, then I'd take the 3 points here. Otherwise, I'd probably just give it to my halfback and let him put his head down and try to get the first.
And this is what power football is all about, folks.
Fires quickly to the tight end.
Tackled around the 16-yard line.
That's good for a game of 14 yards. First down.
Throws it to the outside.
That makes it second.
Second down and 10 to go.
Ball on the 16. And he's tackled right away. Fitzpatrick picks up about 4 yards with a catch.
The Bobcats, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout.
This is the ninth play of this drive.
Kicks away,
and they tack on 3 points.
They might just want to squib this one. Only a few seconds left here before halftime.
Lee gives it at the 7. He got hit hard.
We played a half of football. This one's all even at 10. Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
He'll return this one from the 7. He's out to the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 34.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count.
He's tackled at the 42.
Second and 2.
back's got it on the quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 42-yard line.
Nothing doing for the offense, and it's fourth down.
That makes it fourth and eight.
Green to punt. He's taken down at the 37. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. And he's stopped behind the line. Out to around the 45.
Gain of 8 yards. Third down.
In your face.
He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D.
And he tackles him hard at the 35-yard line.
Gain of 12 on the play. First down.
They bring him down in the backfield. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 37-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. It all going long. Can't haul it in. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. He launches one for the end zone. He caught it. Touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
So they go to the air on fourth down when they needed a big play, and boy, do they come through. He makes the PAT. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
Pistol Pete, as the guns are blazing as Oklahoma State takes the field in Stillwater. And for Texas Tech, they can't afford to lose today's game and expect to make a bowl. And for Ernst, he's caught a pass for a touchdown.
Touchdown difference, Reese, 17-10 here.
Edmund, ready to kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Texas State coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. They'll bring him down at the 27.
That makes it second and six.
gets it. He's in space. He's taken down right around the 36-yard line. Throws middle to the tight end. And he's tackled at about the 41. Scramble. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. Complete. Brought down. Nothing doing. About 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He did not get to the first down marker.
That's a gain of one on the play. That'll make it fourth and two.
He's scrambling. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The quarterback has some room, and he scores. Touchdown. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and restate.
Let's take a look at scores around the country. Let's take yet another peek at this game. And for Oklahoma State, they're looking to win two in a row. The Cowboys are on top, 17-14.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23.
Willis's game so far, what we expected. He's a star. He's playing like one. We're in the third quarter. And he's done everything we expected and then some, I think.
Yeah, I mean, he's just one of those guys that has the ability to take the game over. And, you know, we've seen it all year with him. It's not shocking to see what he's been able to do today, but it is fun to watch. I mean, he makes great decisions. He always seems to be able to be in command of this offense. And up to this point, this defense has not been able to do anything to slow him down.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not.
After reviewing the play, the rule on the field is reversed.
So the call on the field will be reversed. From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. He's got it with room to run. And down he goes at the 27-yard line.
That'll make it 35.
Man, watch out here. Brought down at the 34-yard line.
Gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and 10.
He makes his way to about the 45. So at the end of three, good game here, 17-17. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. There he goes. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
That's good for a game.
Two times.
First down.
Three down, three down.
Hey, check by 47. Check by 47.
He fights forward to about the 43.
That brings us second and nine.
To the receiver, incomplete. Third down again. Going for it all to the end zone. He scores. What a play. Tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
And he hits the PAT. A nice seven-play, 79-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Texas State ready to kick this one off. Bowling fields it at the 11. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Houston's had a really hard time establishing any kind of rhythm on offense today.
Yeah, and we're so used to seeing that from them. They might want to go back and look at this film and try to study to see what they didn't do well, because this is not the type of offense you'd expect to see from these guys.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Quick throw, almost intercepted. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 33. Try and scramble. And he's taken down around the 47-yard line. Throws completely stopped immediately.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch. That's fun to see.
He's still going to be short. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Caught, open field, and they make the stop at the 30. Just under three to go in regulation. Caught with room to work. Tackle at the 22. Goal.
Kicks it to his receiver. Touchdown. And with that touchdown reception, he's now got 10 this year.
I can see now why this quarterback calls him his favorite target. Whenever this guy's near the end zone, he gets him the ball.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 67-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
Good game, 24-24. Houston lines up for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Bobcats have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong. The other team can't do anything right.
You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. Throws it in a hurry. He's tackled at the 26. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Going deep. Oh, and he can't hold on. Third and nine. All on their own 26. The ground incomplete. Lee is back deep to return the punt. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. And for Willis, he's been showing off a full set of skills today.
Well, he's really the X factor. Just when the defense thinks they have him contained, he's able to break away and improvise and pick up 20 more yards running.
All of the other moments in the game have led to this opportunity to lead his team to a win. They're 2 for 2 in finding the end zone on their last two drives. Let's see how they do here.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against his defense.
Nice pitch and catch for the first down. That's a great tackle at the 34. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He fires this one. Puts it right in his hands, touchdown. Houston's star is shining as brightly as he ever has.
It is fun to watch a quarterback do all the preparation, all the work that he needs to be able to do to put himself in a position to mentally and physically have a shot to win the game for his team. And that's exactly what we just saw.
And he adds the extra point. Cooper has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just over a minute left. Back's got it on the quick throw. And he's level at the 31-yard line.
Call it a gain of 9 yards. That brings him second and one.
Kill. Here's a throw, and it's almost picked.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He sails it long. And he's tackled in the open field. That gives him 100 yards in the game.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
And he is drilled at the 21. The slant pattern, good for about 8 yards on the play. The Bobcats are going to call their second timeout. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Catches it, and he's looking for more. They'll bring him down right around the 14-yard line.
That's a game of seven on the play.
Easy. Kill. Next five.
Steps up, caught out in the open. He's taken down around the 10-yard line. The spike will stop the clock. And once again, they'll come to the line, trying to convert on third down. Strike tight end, and that's a touchdown.
Thank you.
Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Play game offense.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He makes the PAT.
Late in the fourth quarter, and with that score, we are now tied. And the way things are going, we might be going to an extra session or two.
They line up to kick this one away. Lee from the eight. He's out. Brought down at the 34-yard line.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
He's on the run. Tackle at the 35. He scrambled, but he didn't get much.
Brad, this defense reacts too quickly for a scramble like that to work. He needs to spread him out a little bit more to try to create more room to run.
We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 35-yard line. Bring him down at the 42-yard line.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play. Check, tight right.
They've got one more shot. Let's see if their prayers will be answered with a good old Hail Mary.
Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game.
Well, that's the end of regulation, and this game is still unsettled, so we're going to overtime.
Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime.
Around the 15-yard line. From the 15-yard line, it's second down. Slings it quickly to his halfback again. He's pushed out of bounds at the 12. Second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Scrambling around. Tries to get around the corner. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Let's take a look at some action in the Big 12. High-powered offenses everywhere. And for Oklahoma State, they become bowl eligible with this win. The Cowboys pull it out by a field goal.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 25. Quickly, and that was almost picked.
That makes it second and 10.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
We've got a dandy here, folks. We're heading to overtime number two.
From the 25-yard line, it's first down. Quick throw, incomplete. Waters receiver. Pushed out of bounds. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
That brings him second.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 6-yard line.
Let's go deep.
Taken down at the two. And they make the stop around the 1-yard line. So the kicker will come out and try to build a 3-point cushion here in overtime. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. Someone wanted a little head start there.
Defense. Automatic first down.
First and five. Ball on the 10-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set.
Exactly what they had to do here to win this football game, and they went out and did it. It's been a battle the entire game, and I don't think there's any doubt that these guys completely deserve this W.
Houston staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good, and I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.